Okay, Carter, so will you hold something for me? I use a lot of little teeny branches and stuff for boys in the garden, something small. And posing a child's hand is the easiest thing in the world. You know, a lot of people try to manipulate children into the pose or try to get children to do things. The only thing I've found that works 100% of the time is if you have something small enough that a child will hold in their hand, they will pose their hands naturally and they won't go all crazy all over the place. Plus, it adds a little bit of interest to the image as well. And you can also do illustrative images where they're pulling leaves and petals and that sort of stuff off. Rocks, twigs, sticks are great for boys, girls, of course the flowers and little, we have little baskets that girls can put flowers and stuff in. But just watch how simple and easy this is. Carter, can you hold that for me, please?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Hey, Carter. Can you step this toe out to me a little bit more like that? And that's about as easy it is to pose a child. Okay, hold right there, bud, okay? And now what I'm gonna do is my flash exposure, ambient exposure, matching one-to-one. Hey, Carter, can you hold that with two hands for me? Oh, I see it. Hey, can you take one of the petals off of that for me? Awesome. How many are left? Can you count them and tell me how many are left? Eight! Golly! Oh, yeah, just love it. That's like deposit, deposit, deposit. Can you hold this with two hands? Step this toe really far out like that. That's great. Okay, stay just like that for me, okay? Don't you move. Now, because I'm working on a tripod too, and Carter hasn't moved, if you noticed, he's in that same position, even while I'm talking to you. So if you keep everything as consistent as possible, all I have to do is fire the camera remotely, and I'm still, again, on manual focus here. I've auto-focused and I put everything into manual focus. Carter. Carter. Ah! Hey, Carter, can you do this? Oh, your head fell off. Why did your head fall off? I don't know either. Does it fall off a lot? Yeah, oh, that's so silly. Hey, Carter, can you cross your feet like this? Yeah, you did it. Wow, that's crazy. Now, I'm working at an aperture that is about f8. So, at f8, Carter can move just a little bit, and I don't have to constantly reset the camera to photograph him, and I can still capture all of these different expressions as we go. Hey, Carter. What are you doing, Carter? Hey, Carter, can you let that little leaf come, hold your hands down like this for me? Okay, good, stand up real tall. That's great, wow, you're Superman. Hey, Carter, can you do this? Can you do this? Here, let me come beside you and do it, you ready? Can we do it together? Okay, I'm gonna do mine over here and you do yours there, okay? All right, so, Carter, can you do this? Look that way though. Look right where Teddy is. Hey Carter, can you do this? Look that way, silly. Can you step your toe out like that? Whoa, it's too much. Can you bring it back a little bit? Oh, that's good. Okay, so stay right there, okay? Let me see this for a second. All right, so all we're gonna do, hold right like that, okay? Don't move. Now I'm gonna work, hopefully I can get a little bit more of a classic. Hey Carter, can you lean your head this way? No, that's too much. Straighten it back up for a second. I'm gonna check the focus just to make sure I didn't move him too far one way or another. Hey Carter, can you turn this way sideways like this? Oh, that's great. Turn around just like you did a minute ago. Oh, can you hold your leaf like this with two hands? Hey Carter. Where's Carter? Ah, ha, ha, ha. Stand up real tall for me. Whoa, not that much tall.
Good, perfect. Okay, so now we have tons of options for the main portrait and some fun stuff too. So I always love to photograph all the way through. Thank you so much. I love to photograph all the way through whatever he's giving me as far as expression and pose. And all of these could be add-on extra panels and things that a mom, although the main portrait, the first couple images that we create are probably gonna be the wall portrait selection for this particular look. Mom's not gonna be able to say no to all of those fun other moments that happen too. And because I did not have to worry about focusing and recomposing the camera by working on a tripod and being in manual focus, I can just let him authentically do whatever he's gonna do. And that'll give Mary a little bit more extra in the sales room. That'll make a little bit more money for us too. So Carter's gonna change clothes and then we're gonna photograph him and show you how you can create a few more illustrative images that look like we did it in a vast space by throwing the background a little bit more out of focus. Carter, you wanna change clothes and then come back out? Okay, let's go. Hey Carter, can you, let me see if Daddy can help you over to that bench and you can sit on that bench. Put your toe up here. Okay, hold right there, okay? You stay right where you are, okay? Hold that right there. Okay, so now I'm gonna work with Carter and do a little bit more loose style, a little bit more illustrative, something that's gonna be a little bit more, that's the shot right there. So you know, the great thing about this is being prepared. You know, when accidents happen and you get that great little look, it's all good. Hey, Carter.
What are you doing, silly?
Hey, Carter. Oh, look at that. That was the right there. Amazing shot. That's great. I love the looking down. Hey, Carter, is there something on your knee? Oh, look, is there something on top of your knee? Oh, what is it? That's so silly. All right, Carter, stay right there. I'm just going to come up for a little bit. Hold there, bud, okay? All right, so now I'm gonna utilize off-camera remote control. So there's tons of different remote controls available to you. This is the MicroSync, I love it. Unfortunately, it's discontinued. If you can find them, they're great. But firing the camera remotely, I'll show you how I can work with him up front and be able to do this. So I'm gonna bring in his dad. Hey, Alex, can you join me for a second? I'm gonna have you just kind of kneel down here just so you keep your head around this area of the camera. Okay. And that way, if I'm gonna work with Carter up beside him, but every now and then I'm gonna have him come and look at you. Okay. Whatever you do, keep your head here. Don't go too far to the left or right, but okay. More right on top, okay? Yeah. All right, Carter. Hey, Carter, what's that right there? What's that right there? Hey, look, watch this. Here, put your elbow on your knee, and look, do you see where your daddy is? Where's your silly daddy? Oh my gosh, I love it. I love the strap off his shoulder. Now normally I would fix that, but for that particular image, I love that little strap off the shoulder. I'm just gonna fix it just so that we have both options. And I'd much rather fix it now than fix it later in Photoshop. I'm gonna get, oh, ow! Hey Carter, can you put both feet up in the chair with you? Can you put your arms around your knees like this? Can you hug your knees with both hands? Here, I'll come help you, okay? Mr. Jamie, come help. Here, hold this too, okay? And can you do like this? I'm gonna scoot you around a little bit. Boom, 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 boom. Can you put your hands together like that? Oh, that's excellent. Okay, now, hey, Carter. Where's Daddy doing? Does he have his sunglasses on his head? Daddy! He's so silly! Hey, Carter, can you look down at your toes? What's on your toe? Can you point to your, can you tickle your toe with that plant? Can you put that plant on your toe? Put that blue thing on your toe. Put it on the other toe. Oh, good job. All I did there was move the main light a little bit, and because, hey, awesome. Okay, so Carter, can you, here, can you stand up in here for me? Yes. All right, I'm gonna help you. Stand all the way up. Okay, so I'm gonna hold this for a second. I'll give it right back, okay? So can you put one hand here and one hand here? Awesome. Can you cross your feet like this? Can you cross one over the other? Okay, good. Stay right there. That's actually really good. I'm going to go back and just check the focus and make sure my cropping and the composition is held up really well. Perfect. Okay. All right, hold right there, Carter. I'm just coming to fix your pants, okay? Really important to make sure all those little details are taken care of, because that can make or break the entire sale by the outfit not being adjusted correctly. So even though we're in an age where we can change all those things, it's still really important to me, because since we are not doing any manipulation to the images prior to the client seeing them, I want to make sure that I do my job and not fall down being lazy by saying we can fix that in post. I'd much rather fix it now. Okay, you ready? That's crazy. Did your tummy stick out? Does it stick out a lot? What? Hey, Carter, can you cross one toe over the other like this? Yeah! Hey, Carter, can you lean like this? Nice. Can you hold onto your suspenders with one hand or two hands? Oh, that's good. Don't you move. Hey, Carter, can you throw your head all the way? Can you take your head off? Does your head come off? No way, silly. Oh, gosh, how cute is that? Now, because I'm getting those kind of great expressions, and actually, Carter being positioned where he is right now, he's not gonna move very far, so now I'm gonna zoom in really close and get some great face shots. Do what? Yeah, no, you can just hold like that. Oh, hold on to your suspenders. Can you hold up like this? Don't you let him go. Carter, don't you let him go, silly. Hey, can you do like this? Can you hide your face like this? Oh, Carter. Okay, now, so let's see. Carter, did you have a hat?
Yes.
Let me see, Carter. Can I wear this hat? Can I put it on my head? You think it'll fit? Huh? Can I put it on your head? Yeah, it's so silly. Okay, so I'm gonna put it on, okay? Hold right like that. Okay. So, here, come with me a second. Okay. So, can you sit down on your knees right there? All the way down, like that? Good. Now, hold just like that for me for a sec, okay? I'll be right back, Carter. I'm just going to check one thing. I'm going to come up a little taller. All of those were from a lower camera angle because of the background. If you look this way, you can see there's houses and cars. And after a while photographing outdoors, I learned this actually from Hanson Fong, is looking at shape and design. So I actually use the leaves and the trees in the background to draw attention and bring the composition back around to Carter's face. So now what I'm going to do is change my angle. It's still going to have the same, it's all going to be photographed in the same location, which is going to help Mary sell a panel of that particular, because that's what I'm envisioning now, is a panel more than just an individual print or two. So now all I'm going to do is recompose. And the cool thing is that I really don't have to do anything to get that look, okay? All I'm doing is recomposing the camera, and then I'm gonna let him do his own thing. Carter, can you put your chin down on your hand like this? Hey, Carter. Hey, Carter, do you know what sound the chicken makes? What does he say? That's right. Hey, Carter, can you put your nose down on your hand? Hey, Carter, look at me. Oh, love that. Hey, Carter, what are you doing? Good. Okay, now, okay, let's do something else. You ready? Here, come with me. You ready? Up we go. All right, can you sit back? I'm gonna have you sit down here like that. Is that okay?
Yes.
Can you scoot all the way to this side? Scoochy, scoochy, scooch. Okay, so. Stay right there for a minute. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is, this is the easiest way to be able to change and get multiple looks without having to shift and move the subject. So I know that in this particular environment, I can photograph in a circle. And most photographers, we get stuck on just one camera angle. If we just stop and walk around the subject, you'll see so many different looks and angles. So what I'm gonna do without moving Carter is I'm gonna swap my main light and the camera and create a whole and unique different look, concentrating mostly closer up. But this is kind of cool because it'll all work within this panel and not use a whole lot of the session time or energy and not break his concentration by having to pick him up and physically move him to another spot. The more concise I can be and the faster I can be in moving things around and getting different angles, the more chances I'll have to get great shots at the end because I'm not wearing him out. I found that, you know, an hour with a child of this age and this attention span is probably the best, because that way every shot from the beginning to the end will give me the best energy level in the entire shot. And this is one of my favorite new areas in the entire garden to photograph. I'm using the ivy that's in front of him as the foreground element. Carter will be in the midground element, and then all the way in the background, I'm gonna position Carter so that he's in the darkest spot of the background with the light going around in a circle. So this will add just a really cool another design element in the background. Now, this is a great shot, but I've got in the back of the image, I have a little bit of blown out highlights. So you can see where in the very back, all of the shrubs are really bright. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna increase my shutter speed, increase the power of the strobe. And of course, I'm doing all that remotely. And now I'm able to get that detail back in the background and still keep the correct exposure on his face. Hey, Carter. Hey, Carter, what are you doing over there? Carter, can you lean like this for me? Oh, that's so fantastic. Hey, what, are you coughing? No way. Hey, Carter, can you look at your left hand? Do you know which hand is your left hand? Which one is your left? Show me. You don't know. Score. That couldn't have asked for anything better than that right there. Hey, Carter. Can you lean like this on the chair? Here, let's put this hand here and this hand here. Open it up.
Put it right there. Open it up. Put it right there.
Look here at me, bud. Can you lean your head right like that? Just gonna adjust the main light a little bit since I'm tipping his head backwards, just so I still get a great pattern of light to the face.
Ha! What are you doing?
Hey, Carter, how about if I bring Teddy in for a picture? Teddy, come here. Sit. You hold this stick, okay? And we'll see if Teddy will catch it, okay? So you hold right there for a second. Carter, see if you can offer Teddy that stick. Teddy? Okay, so see if you can take that stick and point it to Teddy's nose. Hey, Teddy, do you want a treat? Good. So, when working with pets and animals, all you have to do is make sure that you're in the right position, and if you set everything up, hopefully all you have to do is make sure that your subjects act favorably in one of two ways to however you set the image up. So I was able to get that photograph because I could fire the camera remotely and still make it look like a total candid moment. Great job, Carter. Okay, so now we're gonna have Carter change and we're gonna go actually indoors, and I'll show you how we work with children inside.
Wow, Jamie, he did such an amazing, amazing job.
He's fantastic.
Are all of your clients like that?
believe it or not, yes. Occasionally I'll have a child that we hit at the wrong time of day, where we don't pay close attention to nap schedules. Uh-huh. But there's a couple things that I think that work in our favor. You've seen we bake cookies every day in the studio, and they're in a little silver wagon. When the clients come in, I always show the children where the cookies are. Mm-hmm. So if they're really good, they get a cookie when we're done, and we have a toy box too that has toys in it. So if they're extra good, they get a toy as well.
Nice. So two levels of good.
Yes.
Good and extra good.
Absolutely. And you know, you can get these from Oriental Trading, or you can pick them up at the dollar store. They don't have to be anything too amazing. It's just a special gift for a reward, kind of a consequence and reward situation. I also always make sure I check with the parents first that it's appropriate if I give a toy, and if there's any food allergies that we need to worry about as well, and or pet allergies, because with Ted the super dog, you know, I don't want anyone to have any allergic reaction to him.
Do you rent Teddy out for portraits?
No, but he certainly is the perfect portrait dog. He knows how to pose. That's
He's
for sure.
been really great.
He is amazing.
Can we talk for a second about gear? Because the thing that I just kept looking at and I was so amazed by, you don't work with an assistant with small children. And this concept of remote firing and you being wherever you need to be. And at one point you picked the light up and you made it, you know, more of a profile light. Like, I was like, yeah, that's awesome. That's so amazing. So tell me just a little bit about your gear.
Sure. So the one thing that works there, again, I'm working on a tripod. So as long as the subject doesn't move forward or backward, and as long as I don't move the camera forward or backward, I can use autofocus to lock focus in on the subject. My aperture, if I use a high enough aperture, it will give me a depth of focus that child can move forward or backward a little bit and still be acceptably sharp. Now, by acceptably sharp, I mean, in these particular images, I'm not looking for the wall portrait pose out of here. It's add-on sales at this point.
Right.
So, you know, the biggest that it would be is maybe a 5x7, maybe an 8x10 at the most. So a little bit of motion in that is not going to kill the sale where it would in the wall portrait. But by firing the camera remotely and being able to have equipment that I can operate remotely and change the power remotely. Over the years, I've tried everything, okay? I've had cords, I've had radio controls, I've had all kinds of stuff. And right now, this is the simplest and easiest that I've found to work.
It was fascinating to watch you, watch you work.
It's also lightweight too. So by just having the camera and the tripod and the light, I don't feel exhausted at the end of the day. Even if I had 8 sessions, which would be the most I would ever do in a day,
I'm
still not totally exhausted at the end of the day.
Right. So tell me what this is. It's just a...
So this is the MicroSync. This is a radio transmitter that fires cameras or strobes remotely. Unfortunately, this product isn't available anymore. If you can find them, buy all that you can. These were manufactured by Tamrac Bag Company. And I was kind of a part of helping the training and doing trade show things for them because the product is so amazing. Everything I use, and I love to test all kinds of different equipment. Mm-hmm. But I'm only going to use anything that allows me to do what I do naturally.
Right.
So
right,
I'm not a, we don't have a lot of gear. I know a lot of my friends have bags of lenses and bags of stuff. I can do 90% of everything with that one lens and the remote control. Any remote control though that's a radio control will allow you to do kind of the same thing as long as it'll trigger a camera.
That's great. And then you're using Profoto lights.
Profoto B1s. I've used a lot of different things over the years, and this is just absolutely amazing. It's TTL. It's high speed sync. Not that I'm using those features, but if I choose that I'm in a situation where I want to use those, that's all built in.
Oh, that's great.
Now, I probably wouldn't have to use a meter. I'm just faster at using a light meter than I am at getting my exposure correct on TTL and then shifting the light into manual. And that's one of the features of this particular strobe. Also, the great thing is that the remote control has the radio built in, so it's all one thing.
Gotcha.
Which is fantastic. And then the battery operated area of this is great. I also use the LED modeling light. It's a 3000 degree Kelvin LED modeling light at weddings if I want to do match and tungsten background.
Okay.
I can put tungsten light on the subject's face too.
Yeah.
So it really gives you such a wide range, and it's lightweight and power and portable. I think I can get like up to 20,000 exposures on low power and up to 200 on full power, and that's 500 watt seconds battery operated.
That's
and
amazing.
The batteries can rapid charge in an hour.
Wow. And then that the light box.
Yeah, the softbox is great. This is actually made by a photographer. It's XP Photo Products. And what I really love about it is the flexible rods. Because all you have to do is blow over any softbox, really, and the rods
that are... I've done that quite a few times.
Will bend, yeah. So I love the fact that this will... and it collapses really quick. You hit two buttons, and the whole thing collapses really quick and sets up really easy, too.
That's great.
Which is fantastic. Once I find a product, I use it a lot. Now, I've changed a little bit of the brand of softboxes that I've used, but I haven't changed the size, because the size of the light source, mm-hmm. or the modifier, and the distance it is to the subject controls the contrast. And the contrast controls the mood and feeling. So I keep this really consistent for a couple reasons. This is the same way I've created every image that I can remember for the past 30 some years. So I can match portraits of different siblings at different times. Photographing Carter, the earlier shots that we did for the main portrait pose, Carter's mom is expecting another child. So when baby number two gets here, there'll be about 3 or 4 years difference in their age. But once she makes the selection for Carter's portrait, that second sibling, I'll be able to match and create a complementary portrait, whether they face each other or face opposite, at that point in time. But I'll know exactly how I've created every image, and there's no guesswork. If you can streamline your process down to where it's so simple and easy with the fewest amount of gear, but works for everything. And a good example is I could photograph a family of 100 right here, right now, the exact same way, and I would light it the same way. So I don't have to have a different formula for, I want to do a shallow depth of field image with one subject, and then I want to do, the next is a group of 100. So there's a fewer chance of photographer error on that part, but by having that one system, I never have to reinvent the wheel. I don't have to carry a lot of stuff or get to a location and say, oh my gosh, I forgot the adapter that goes to this product because this is my big family on location lighting, and now I've only was working with my available light, close focus, shallow depth of field equipment.
Well, and it also builds your brand.
Yes.
I mean, people, it's recognizable when you look at your portraits. They're very recognizable. Yeah.
You know, sometimes I kind of feel that we're really traditional and old school and old fashioned. And then, you know, I get situations where we create that amazing image and the parents are like, oh my gosh, this is so different from everything else that we've had created for us. I know we're in the right, we're doing exactly what we're supposed to do.
Absolutely.
And that's our goal here, really, is to stand out from the crowd. So people, I think clients don't see what's similar, they see what's different.
Right, right. So if they're seeing a lot of lifestyle, a lot of shallow depth of field, this is kind of opposite, the opposite
it
thing.
It is exactly opposite. And let's face it, everyone right now, currently, all photographers start off as lifestyle photographers because they don't like the interaction, or they don't like working with children, or they don't want, they're not really good at posing and not good at anything that's
or
not
natural
lighting. Correct. So because that is so, that's the norm. That's where the bar is currently right now, I think, is natural light, lifestyle, I'll come to your home and photograph your children. Nothing, there's anything wrong with that whatsoever. It's just that when everyone in the marketplace is doing that, then the only thing a client can select you by is price.
Right.
Because everything's the same.
Good point.
So that's why we try to keep our brand true to what we do. Because if the client is going to invest their time and energy to come to me, I want to make sure it's not only worth their while, it's worth my while as well.
Awesome. Jamie, thank you so much.
You're so welcome.